Right away. I do so.
I was dreaming. It was like a locker room setting, but it was supposed to be my work. And these people were coming in and taking their clothes off, and I could see how really slim people were. And then my father came in, and he was really pissed drunk, and he didn't have his false teeth in, so his face was all sucked in. But, like, he had them in, but he came in and he sat down and he took the false teeth out while he was sitting down at the table talking to two men that I worked with. There were supposed to be people working at Polyfab, but they were really people that I've worked with over the years. I remember one was Tom Knight. I don't know who the other person was. And then, anyway, I was real embarrassed, and I said, Dad, like, you can't do this here, right? Like, this is where I work, and I'm really embarrassed. Let's go. So I took them to what was supposed to be their home, which was like a really science class-like room. And I opened the door, and I took him in. My mother kind of threw him in a corner behind some kind of high thing that he couldn't see him. And she started screaming at me, and she was all really made up, like really a lot of makeup and looked really wicked. And she starts kicking me and everything because I brought my dad home like that, and it was all my fault, and how I should be taking care of them. And I said, why the fuck should I be taking care of you? And she said, because she was old, we should be taking care of, you know, I should be taking care of them. And she was kicking me, and I started screaming and screaming and screaming. And I tried to kick open the door, which was like a science door, and screaming for someone to help me. And no one came, but then somehow I ended up back at my work. And in the washroom, which was like a washroom in the store or a bar, and one of the doors in the washroom was like a refrigerator. And you could put eggs on the outside and stuff, and it would keep on the outside of the bathroom door. But anyway, I went in and I looked, and there was like 8 stalls, and one of the doors was like really closed, so I wasn't sure if there was someone in there using it or not, so I was really scared. So then I went and I got Raymond. I said, Raymond, I know this is really embarrassing, but do you mind coming in with me while I go to the bathroom? Because I really trusted Raymond that he wouldn't do anything to me, and it was okay if Raymond came in while I went to the bathroom, and he'd be able to look after me. So he came in, and then somehow Mary got in there too, and so I had my dress on, my pink dress, and it's long, and so I kept it over myself so no one could see anything while I was going to the bathroom. While I really only intended to pee, and I ended up doing other stuff too, and I was real embarrassed by it. They somehow were talking, and they didn't really notice that I done anything else. So then we left there, and then a lady I see on the bus every morning going to the sweatshop on Western Road, she was like, she was working on Polyfab, and it was like a school hall, and she came in, she said, oh, it's really raining hard outside, and she took off. And then Mary and I were going to take a cab, and just as we were leaving, like, there was a white stretch limo, really long white stretch limo, with someone sitting in the back seat, and I said, wow, that's my old boyfriend Kirk. And he got out of the stretch limo that was up by a hotel, but I couldn't see the hotel. You could just see like really steep stairs leading up to a hotel where you'd be welcomed. And then the person got out of the stretch limo and was walking. I said, wow, that's Kirk, right? And then I noticed it had a skirt on. I said, I guess it can't be Kirk, it's a woman. And I watched it walk up the stairs. It walked up to the top of the stairs and then wiped out. So then I wiped out, and all these people from the hotel came rushing to help. But well, then Mary and I, we were supposed to take a cab, and Marco showed up. So Mark showed up, and he was driving along this country road, and there was, on the right-hand side, there was people with these dogs with pups. And it said, you know, pups and for sale, air cries only, meaning, like, that they made air cries only, meaning that they just opened their mouth, but nothing came out, like, no sound, so, like, it was cool, they wouldn't get on your nerves or anything, they just cried, but they only made air cries, so you could see that they were crying, but they didn't make no noise, so they were nice. And we were sort of talking about buying dogs, but, you know, I've got Herman, and they didn't need a dog or whatever. And I had to explain to them what air cries were, because I knew, but no one else knew. And then we kept driving, and there was a field on the left-hand side by Marco and I. Mark was driving, and I was behind him. And it was had huge cucumber leaves, So like it really wasn't cucumbers, but all over the field. And then we said, Mark, why are you driving in the country? We're just supposed to be going down Western Road. Mark, why are you driving in the country? Mary said, Mark, why are we driving in the country? And Mark, he didn't really know why we were driving in the country, and that was the end of the dream.
Possible titles for the film: Air Cries. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah.